So chapter 6, part D, commercial tenancy. Commercial lease can be granted for a fixed period. Lease shows commencement date and length before commencement of lease. No matter how long or short, 1 week to 99 year lease. Right? So you can hire 1 week to 99. So it shows the beginning, it shows the end. Commencement means when it starts, right? Automatically end when term is over. For example, if 1 year lease start May 1st, so April 30th automatically ends. So either May 1st, April 30th. If start January 1st, when does it end? December 31st. But if tenant stays and pays rent and landlord accepts it, then tenancy has now become a period of tenancy, which comes in the exam mostly. So you have 1 year lease, both party agree, right? What happens after 1 year? It becomes a period. Law would imply the same period as if you can't change anything, everything remains the same. Note, any lease dealing with the residential property over 20 years, had over 20 years, must be dealt with as a commercial tenancy. Do you understand? If somebody leases a place over 20 years, it becomes automatically commercial. Periodic term automatically renews itself only last day, highlight this, last day renews for a further term of the same length, higher same length, until it is terminated by either party with proper notice. So this one you see in the exam. You may see this one as a definition and say, what do we call it? It's called periodic. Or maybe periodic there, then you have to find out what it is. A periodic commercial lease can be created in two ways. Number one, express term of lease. Express means clear term. It can be weekly, monthly, or yearly. By implication of law, tenant stays on after the fixed term lease ends, pays rent, and landlord accept. Implication basically means you just basically imply. Imply means, for example, I have a lease for 1 year. After 1 year, what happens? Yes. Both party agrees. I am paying, he is accepting. It's automatically a period. Okay? What would be the length of the renewal? Not fixed. But if the original agreement stated yearly in the lease agreement, if the original say yearly, the rent was expressed as a yearly. The law would imply they have renewed the original agreement so far as another year. If I did for 1 year before, after 1 year both parties continues to pay and accept, so then it becomes one more year. Then proper notice is required. One renter period for weekly, monthly, and 6 month notice for a yearly. So I have one rental period. If it's a weekly, so then one rental period, 1 week. If it's monthly, then 1 month. And 6 month for a yearly. So 6 month for a yearly. Termination of a commercial period of lease, a tenancy. Either party can terminate commercial by giving reasonable notice. So either party, reasonable. One rental period is reasonable for weekly or monthly, which we did before. 6 months for a yearly. The form of notice is unimportant as long as it indicates the intention to terminate. Basically, there needs to be intention to terminate. Termination of commercial term tenancy. It would end when the lease is over, not before. So, question normally in the exam it comes, how much notice do you need? No notice is required for a fixed term tenancy. When at the last day, it automatically ends, right? And tenancy at will, commercial. Tenants has the permission of the landlord to occupy the premises, but it can be terminated at any time by either party. Residential. This is not really mentioned in the Residency Act. It says the minimum notice to terminate agreement is 10 days. Tenant can, within 10 days, give a notice and can walk away. Tenant can walk away. But the landlord, how much? 2 months. Then commercial. Fixed. Landlord cannot raise the rent during the term. Periodic. Not so protected under the periodic tenancy. Landlord can terminate the tenancy with proper notice and at the same time or later. Advise the tenant that if he wishes to stay on, a new lease must be entered into at a higher rent. Basically mean after 1 year he can say, you know, I'll charge more, right? Distress. Distress in commercial, landlord can seize and sell tenant goods to satisfy a claim. If you don't pay rent, he gives just send one simple letter, right? If you don't listen to him, he can sell your stuff, even personal stuff. Deposit. No restriction to rent increase other than marketplace, open for negotiation. So basically deposit is negotiable. Deposit is negotiable. Privacy. Does the landlord have the right to enter into your rented premises? Look to the term of the lease agreement, whatever you write there, right? But it is common for the landlord to have unrestricted right to enter the premises for inspection at any time. So I have for inspection at any time. Repair. Caveat lefty. Let the tenant beware. Basically, you have to let him know. The tenant must satisfy the suitability of the premises before entering into lease. Basically, in commercial, normally who does the repair? Tenant does. But it all depends how you write in a lease. Sometimes you say, okay, landlord pays and give a 6 months free. Right? It depends how you write. Next, this is very important. Interest termination. Commercial, common law doctrine of interest termination, which says that no estate in land parcels, no estate in land parcels until the tenant takes possession. If the landlord does not let the tenant into the premises at the beginning of his lease, the landlord will be able for damages. Tenant can only sue for example, you are leasing a place, but the landlord has not given you possession yet. If he doesn't give you possession, what you can do to him? You can sue him. But you can sue him only for damages, not for possession. But once you have the possession, it's okay. But before the possession, you can only sue him for damages. So highlight only for damages. Highlight this, mostly comes. But in residential, abolished under the Real Estate Act, so tenant can obtain an order for possession, highlight order for possession, against the landlord. The residential tenant is not limited to damages. But if it's a residential, right, once you lease the place, if the landlord doesn't give you possession, you can legally get the possession too. You are not only limited to damages. In commercial, only damages. But in residential, you can get both possession and damages. And quiet enjoyment does not mean freedom from noise. Don't translate into Punjabi. Commercial common law, it assures that tenant use and enjoyment of the property free from interference, or free from interference of the landlord, and assurance to the tenant against the consequence of a defective title. Highlight defective title. If someone new landlord tries to say you don't have a right to be living here, it would breach the covenant of quiet enjoyment.